the dawn of timekeeping. The first signs of humans tracking time date back to around 20,000 BCE. Archaeological finds, such as the Lubombo bone and the Ashango bone, show evidence of notched markings. These ancient artifacts found in Africa are believed to represent lunar phase tracking, marking the passage of days and perhaps months. Around 4000 BCE, the Sumerians developed one of the earliest calendars based on the lunar cycles. This system allowed them to predict the best times for planting and harvesting crops. The Sumerians also created one of the earliest sundials, using the position of the sun to measure the hours of the day. By 3000 BCE, the ancient Egyptians had refined the lunar calendar. They created a solar-based calendar with 12 months of 30 days each, plus 5 extra days to complete the solar year. They used obelisks as giant sundials, their shadows marking the passage of time throughout the day. Around 2000 BCE, the Babylonians introduced a significant advancement with their base 60 sexagesimal numbering system. This mathematical framework profoundly influenced how we measure time today, including the division of an hour into 60 minutes and a minute into 60 seconds. The Egyptians' innovation continued around 1500 BCE with the development of water clocks, or clepsydra. These devices measured time by the regulated flow of water from or into a container. Unlike sundials, water clocks could measure time at night and were used extensively in various civic and religious contexts. By 800 BCE, Greek scholars adopted and improved upon the Egyptian sundial, refining its design to increase accuracy. Around 400 BCE, the Greeks also advanced water clock technology, incorporating mechanical gears to improve precision. The most famous example is the Tower of the Winds in Athens, which featured a complex system of sundials, water clocks, and a wind vane to indicate time and weather. The Roman Empire, known for its pragmatic adoption and enhancement of foreign innovations, embraced Greek timekeeping technologies around 200 BCE. They introduced sundials and water clocks throughout their vast territories, spreading these methods to Western Europe. Roman engineering prowess allowed them to create more robust and reliable timekeeping devices, which became central to managing their extensive and highly organized society during the Islamic Golden Age, approximately 800 CE. Scholars and inventors made significant strides in timekeeping. Islamic astronomers and engineers developed more accurate astronomical clocks, using intricate mechanisms to track celestial movements. These innovations were crucial for determining prayer times and the Islamic calendar. Simultaneously, around 1000 CE, Chinese inventors like Su Song created sophisticated water-powered mechanical clocks. Su Song's clock tower in Kaifeng featured a complex escapement mechanism which regulated the flow of water to ensure consistent timekeeping. This innovation marked a significant leap towards more accurate mechanical clocks. The Renaissance era, characterized by a resurgence of scientific inquiry and technological innovation, saw the advent of the mainspring around 1500 CE. This development allowed for the creation of portable clocks and watches, making personal timekeeping more accessible. In 1583, Galileo Galilei's discovery of the isochronism of pendulums laid the groundwork for more precise timekeeping. He observed that the time a pendulum takes to swing back and forth is constant, regardless of the arc of the swing. This principle revolutionized timekeeping, leading to the development of the first pendulum clock by Christian Huygens in 1656. Huygens' clock significantly improved accuracy, with a margin of error of only a few seconds per day. The Industrial Revolution brought about a surge in technological advancements. John Harrison's development of marine chronometers in the mid-18th century addressed the critical problem of determining longitude at sea. His highly accurate timepieces allowed sailors to calculate their position more precisely, revolutionising navigation and greatly reducing maritime risks. In 1879, Sir Sandford Fleming proposed the idea of worldwide standard time zones, a concept necessitated by the expansion of railways and the need for synchronised schedules. Fleming's proposal led to the establishment of Coordinated Universal Time, UTC, which remains the standard for global timekeeping. The quest for precision in timekeeping reached new heights with the invention of the atomic clock in 1949. Using the vibrations of cesium atoms, atomic clocks offered unparalleled accuracy. By 1967, the definition of the second was redefined based on these vibrations, enhancing the precision of international time standards. In the 21st century, the development of optical lattice clocks promises even greater precision. These clocks, which use lasers to trap and measure the oscillations of atoms, could potentially redefine the second once again in the future. And there you have it, the dawn of timekeeping. For more content like this, comment, like, and subscribe to Chronometers.